A pleasant good evening, viewers. My name is Javon Wilson, and it is an absolute pleasure to be back on your screens for 284 Media. Another exclusive. Tonight, we are speaking to the team from the BVI Health Services Authority. As you may know, we are currently observing Diabetes Awareness Month. So they are here to tell us about a month of activities that is aimed at raising awareness and also sensitizing the public on how to help persons dealing with that particular health issue. Now, while it is very prevalent in our region, the team at BVI Health Services Authority is very confident that with the proper care coupled with help from your loved ones, definitely persons will see a positive outcome. So again, tonight we are in studio with Dr. Calissa Cruikshank as well as Dr. Shayna K. Fraser, both under the umbrella of BVI Health Services Authority, to tell us all about their inaugural month of activities. Stick with us.
You value traditions.
Today.
You value music. You value education. Family.
I love you.
Service.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Love. Life. At Popular, we're committed to you and everything our community values. For the things you value the most, count on us. Popular.
Viewers, welcome back to 284 Media. As promised, two beautiful faces in studio under the BVI Health Services Authority umbrella. First up, we have Ms. Calissa Cruikshank. She is the Registrar of Internal Medicine, a GP with extended role in diabetes and endocrinology management. And we also have Dr. Shayna K. Fraser. She is the lead clinician, Virgin Gorda Anegada Clinics, as well as Primary Care Services Department at BVI Health Services Authority. Welcome, ladies.
Hi, Javon. Thank you for having us.
Thank you, Javon, for having us.
Excellent. Now, we are in the midst of observing Diabetes Awareness Month. You ladies have a front seat, I will believe, as it relates to viewing this disease, not only what it looks like, but how it really affects those persons who are diagnosed with it. So just to bring it home a little bit, I want to ask, how prevalent of an issue is diabetes in the BVA?
All right, so I'll go first. So diabetes is quite prevalent in our community. The statistics shows that 1 in 10 persons are diabetic. And I think 1 in 2 persons are undiagnosed diabetic, right? Wow. And with our outreach, what we often do, we try to sensitize persons to what the risk factors are for developing diabetes and also what symptoms they may experience. Because most persons, unfortunately, is only when they sometimes develop a complication of diabetes that's when they're often diagnosed.
So you're saying 1 in 10 in the BVI, and as it relates to the undiagnosed cases, it may be 2 in 10. Now, one of the things I recognized recently is studies are showing that younger and younger people are being diagnosed with diabetes. Why do you think that is?
Well, I think that can be due to several things, several reasons. Most commonly, obesity. Right, obesity is a risk factor for diabetes, that's one. Other than that, I would also say the diet, right? The diet is the central part of our livelihood, and it can increase your risk of not only diabetes, but other lifestyle diseases as well. Also too, most younger persons, I'm not sure how of their health-seeking behavior. Right, in the BVI or in the Caribbean, we tend to normalize obesity.
Yes.
And the risk factors is not seen as an issue, so therefore persons don't usually do any intervention regarding that. And like I said, the health seeking behavior really does determine how well someone, you know, would take care of themselves.
Right. It seems as if it's going to require more of a holistic approach in dealing with this issue. Would you agree with that?
Most definitely, Javon, I do agree. And to add to it, there has been quite a change in culture regarding our food habits. The Western diet has become very Caribbean now. our grandparents would have, you know, been walking miles, eating grown provisions. And typically everybody drives now, and they can get fast food from any corner around. So portion sizes, what we're eating, how we're eating, when we're eating, how much we're moving about, definitely have contributed to diabetes being on the up and coming. And it's not just in the BVI, it's the Caribbean and the whole world generally. And that's why we are seeking to really be on board this month. The entire month, the theme pretty much is access to care, if not know when. So we're trying to sensitize the community at large, specifically within the BVI. How do you go out there seeking care? Care for myself, my family member. Should I wait until something is wrong or I'm feeling off to go to the doctor? You know, try to have that health-seeking behavior. Let's get screening. But the onus is on us, the healthcare authority, to be able to go out, outreach into the community and catch people before, you know, they show up with symptoms, definitely. So that's the whole gist of this month's whole group of events.
Yes. And you did mention earlier on some of those early signs and trying to detect them. What would you say are some of the first signs that persons can look at and identify and say, hey, you know, this might be an indication that, you know, I may be diabetic?
All right. So a few of the signs, the symptoms that the persons may experience, they can experience excessive thirst, excessive urination, cuts that take very long to heal. Some persons may also have blurred vision and also weight loss. But however, what you find is persons tend to explain away these symptoms to other things, and they aren't usually seen as a collective group of symptoms.
So
if you're feeling unwell, you have any one of those symptoms that I just mentioned, and you may have a family history of diabetes, or you're just concerned, then you can just, like Dr. Fraser said, you know, you want to promote that health-seeking behavior. You can go and see your private doctor, your GP, or, you know, one of the nurses at the clinic, and just have your sugar checked to just make sure that may not be the cause of your symptoms.
You mentioned a very important point, something I really wanted to get to, family history. So this means that diabetes is also a genetic disease.
Right, so broadly, there are two types, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is the genetic form, right? Type 2 is more lifestyle, but however, there are some in-between classifications that are not quite type 2 or not quite type 1, right? But regardless of whether it's genetic or not, the treatment remains the same, which we try to correct your A1C, keep within a normal range to decrease your long-term effects, and in doing so, decrease the complications of that person that can be due to diabetes. So yes, there is a genetic cause, right? However, not everyone has that risk factor, but some persons do. And even though you may have that risk factor, it's still important to ensure that you have a healthy lifestyle.
Understood. Now, clearly, in order to deal with this issue, which has been around forever, I know awareness is key, and the education that you mentioned initially, Dr. Fraser, the importance of really edifying the public on what it is, how they can begin to identify it, but also what help and support is available out there. And I know you guys have set out on a dynamic month of activity. So let's just get into that. What are we looking at? I know we've begun yesterday, right? The first activity would have been yesterday.
Well, the first activity on calendar, but we officially started the first week with the 4th of November in Virgin Gorda.
Okay.
So we have two different main groups of approach. First, we want to definitely be out there in the community and have their focus or their whole aim prioritized, meaning we bring all the caregivers who are involved in diabetes, and it's not just the doctor and the nurse, there are other care providers, the nutritionist, the mental health therapist, the eye specialist, you know, the dentist, all of these different groups of persons, and of course, or food providers. They're key. They're very much key. So we've planned two main symposiums. One will be on the 10th tomorrow at the Upper Room Victory Church in East End, and all these key players will come. Be right there for the community to come in to understand what we're about. You can get your screens done right there on site, and whatever recommendations you need to know where you go to see the nutritionist. If I need to talk to someone about my diagnosis or my family member's diagnosis, that sort of you know, hands-on service is there. But also, we'd like to also speak to the caregivers themselves and the various disciplines that are involved. So we'll be having actual continuing medical education sessions that will be on the 18th, if I remember. At the BVIHSA lobby. And we have three main topics. We have our pharmacist, clinical pharmacist, Dr. Wins, who will be just talking about access to medication in the BVI and how difficult it is. And doctors will understand the medications that are available. We'll have our internist, Dr. Bovell Chichester, who will be talking about renal disease and diabetes. And then we will have Dr. Stout Otley, who will be discussing the skin and diabetes. So that's more of an academic session. Another academic session we'll be having is where we've done a bit of an audit on clients who've come in through all the endocrine clinics, and just to see the picture, the demographics of persons, how the clinic is helping them, and how we can go further, you know, to prevent the disease later on by getting to know what they look like currently. Another health talk we'll be having also at Church of God of Holiness in East End Community. And that is a one-on-one with
a more intimate setting.
More intimate setting where persons can speak to the specialist, get eye checks done as well. But lastly, another outreach that we've try to meet people where they are, because we find that the majority of persons diagnosed with diabetes are in the working age. They're working class. There are people who are going out 9 to 5, getting the job done, bringing home, you know, the bread.
So finding that time is hard.
Exactly. Very hard. So we've developed these mobile clinics where we've gone into the business places, gone into construction companies. That's what we did in Virgin Gorda last week. And we'll be going into the schools. We went to the school yesterday.
Yesterday was a wonderful
time. Both the teachers and the students really appreciated our presentation. And we'll be going to Anigada doing the same, and it's just changing the approach. Instead of waiting on someone to come into the clinic or come into the hospital, we're taking the time to go out there and catch persons.
And that's excellent. And what I'm also hearing, and I hope our viewers really capture that, is the fact that these outreach programs are being extended to our sister islands as well. You mentioned
most definitely
Anagata, Virgin Gorda. So everyone collectively can capitalize on that. And when exactly is World Diabetes Day?
So World Diabetes Day is the 14th of November, so that's Sunday.
Okay.
Right, this Sunday. And it's a universal day where persons focus on bringing diabetes awareness to their communities. Right, so for us at the BVHSA, though World Diabetes Day just the 14th, we wanted to, as Dr. Fraser said, have a month of outreach, right? Sensitizing persons, educating them about diabetes, their risk factors, and the services they have available to them. This is a first for us.
Yes,
right.
This is a first for us.
So it has been quite exciting so far. We have met so much persons, so many people from different communities, and we have learned a lot as well. Myself, mostly I work in the hospital, do offering some support to the community. Dr. Fraser, she works in Virgin Gorda, treating the community there, and it was just interesting to meet, you know, the other, just to see how the other clinics work.
Yes.
And see what we need to improve upon or what we need to, you know, to do to make sure that this is something that continues.
Yes. Right. Yeah. And just playing in on the whole theme, access to care, mm-hmm. we've gone ahead and done, you know, the public-private partnerships.
Right. Yes.
In terms of expanding the services yes. available. Because we know the hospital may not have, or primary care department may not have all the specialties involved.
Yes.
But it doesn't stop us from, you know, prioritizing the client and what they need.
Absolutely.
So we've gone out and made those partnerships there.
Yeah, and another important point is that, like you said, making the partnerships, because diabetes required a multidisciplinary approach. It's not a one-man show.
Yes.
It's not only one person treating it. It, everyone from the healthcare staff to the family members, the patients, you know, as well as you rightfully said, the food providers, everyone has a role to play when managing diabetes.
Absolutely. Now, before you go, I want to touch on the situation regarding dialysis, because I know ultimately, if you know, we're not to, you know, put a handle on the disease, mm-hmm. that is ultimately what it leads to. And I know that has to be, you know, a very challenging situation, not only for the individuals affected, but mm-hmm. also for our health authorities as well. What is the situation like as it relates to dealing with dialysis? Are we in a position where we're aptly able to cater to those patients? Or is it a situation where we really need persons to pay attention to their health so it doesn't have to resort to that particular level?
All right, so regarding the kidney disease, cardiovascular disease is a complication of poorly controlled diabetes. And it is quite true that we do have a large dialysis population. And regarding the level of care, what we aim for is individualized care for each person that we see, and whatever treatment is necessary to ensure that a person has the best quality of life. Mm-hmm. So at the hospital at the dialysis unit, often persons, once you've been diagnosed with diabetes, we would monitor your kidney function at your regular clinic appointments. And there are some persons with their kidneys do get to the point where it's not working as well, and the dialysis is to help them, is to replace the function that the kidneys would have done normally.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It's not a death sentence,
mm-hmm.
right? You can still be a productive member of society, live a full life, still travel, enjoy the things that you used to. However, you would just have to be a bit more careful with your diet and adhere to your medications a little bit more. In my personal experience, some persons are very fearful of dialysis.
Okay.
Because yes, it does have its benefits, but also there are some complications that can arise.
Mm-hmm.
But with the outreach that we're doing, we want to stop persons even before the diabetes. So they won't have to worry about dialysis or kidney problems, because we, like Dr. Fraser mentioned before, we're going out into the communities, we're offering health check screening persons for the risk factors for diabetes, so that we can even prevent that long-term effect,
mm-hmm.
In organ damage, whether it's damage to the kidneys, the heart, the eyes, the brain. We want to stop that from even taking place, if possible.
All right, and I know as well, diabetes also leads to other increased complications with other diseases.
Yes.
So we want to really get a hold on that as well. I want to thank you both for coming to share with us. It's a very important issue that needs to be addressed in the community. And again, it begins with the awareness, with the education.
Yes.
A lot of persons may be familiar with the disease. A lot of persons may be dealing with the disease, but not a lot of persons may be aware of the assistance and the help that is available out there. So I want to thank you once again, Dr. Kalissa Cruikshank, mm-hmm. as well as Dr. Shayna K. Fraser, both of you guys for representing the BVI Health Services Authority, umbrella. And family here, and of course, wish you all the best as you embark on this month of activities.
All right, thank you so
much. Thank you so much for having us, Javon.
You are welcome. And of course, viewers, you can follow their Facebook page, BVI Health Services Authority, to keep up with the amazing work that our frontliners are doing as we continue to pivot our way through this COVID-19 pandemic and still being able to address many of the chronic issues like diabetes that persons are dealing with in the community. For now, that is all the content we have. I want to thank you so much for joining us. And of course, have a good night. Bye-bye.